Look at, this thing's coming off.
Wow, dude, he's chucking along now.
She's going down.
Oh!
Before they get this show on the road, let's remember how we got here.
Look, Mom, no handyman.
Reality star Rob Mariano and monster trucker Dennis Anderson have used 61 ways.
Oh, yeah, we're making some time now.
To get from Los Angeles more than three quarters of the way around the world. To Calcutta, India.
Yeah!
Now in the home stretch.
This is like bumper boats, dude.
Our guys must navigate the backwaters of southern Thailand on their way to Bangkok.
Woo!
Rob, you think we should really be doing this, dude?
Can they find enough ways to get home safely?
This is Bangkok, baby!
Or will they get stuck in the mud?
Three, two, one.
The countdown starts now.
Blast off!
Rob Mariano and Dennis Anderson are circling the globe using 80 forms of transportation. Without repeating a single one, it's around the world in 80 ways.
You gotta be kidding me.
I'd seen this on a movie, James Bond Island. I never thought I'd see the day that I'd be here.
This is it. This is the actual island where, you know, the villain lived in that movie.
Right.
The boys start their trip in Thailand on the famous floating island of Koh Tapu, just off the southern Thai province of Phuket.
What we need to do is we got to get from James Bond Island to Bangkok, and that's going to be up to you, world traveler.
The boys need to get from the small island of Phuket, 500 miles to the capital city of Bangkok, the last destination before heading stateside.
Well, we could take these longboats.
That'd be cool. You got a nice looking longboat there.
Don't talk about my longboat. What do you think this is? I'm a married man over here.
For the first leg of the journey, the guys will be using Thai longtail boats.
My motor is actually an older motor than Rob's. It's an Isuzu diesel motor. It was a turbocharged, but they make them naturally aspirated because they don't need all that torque holding this thing on the stick, buddy. I'm going to tell you, it's a job. But this thing puts out anywhere from 175 horsepower to 180 horsepower. With the turbo on it, it put out about 210 to 215 horsepower.
But no two longtail boats are the same.
Yours is serpentine belt drive. I got V-drive belts because mine is 1979. Yours is about a 2003 over there.
Native to Southeast Asia, longtail boats get their name from the long metal drive shafts, which give the boats their distinct look. Salvaged car or truck engines provide the thrust, but because they aren't made for use in the water, long drive shafts are added to keep them up and dry. This design means the engine is also the rudder. Turning the boat means muscling the entire engine, all 800 pounds of it. We gave the guys boats, but we didn't give them keys.
How do I drive this thing?
Click to push those two wires together. When it fires up, break them apart, pull it in gear, and this is your steering. All right, fire in the hole. Let's get it.
Let's go.
All right, let's go.
Locals hold races regularly to see who can mod up the fastest boat. Winners make good money advertising their boat building skills to other locals.
Whoa. Whoa.
And it takes just as much skill to drive one.
Dude, it's not easy to turn it.
Tell you what, everything I drive is wide open, but this thing right here is a handful. It's tough to drive.
Mother, it's killing my damn back, dude.
These boats turn using the principle of thrust vectoring. By changing the angle of thrust, you change the direction the boat is moving. Dennis gets off to a healthy lead.
Come on, get ahead of me.
While Rob figures out how to handle the 800-pound block V8.
Almost took his head off. Oh, no.
Damn. Rob Mal done me in right then, buddy. Thing's hard to control, but he about run me over. You better watch yourself.
Whoa. I got it now.
Dennis backs off. Getting to the dock first isn't worth his life.
Okay, we made it.
It wasn't bumper boats, dude.
I'm sorry, I almost took your head off. I didn't mean
yeah,
to.
Yeah, I appreciate that, dude.
It got a little bit out of control. I lost
you bent
it
my rudder?
Huh?
You bent my rudder, bent my shaft?
Did it really?
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah. That was one long way. You know how close you come to killing us, dude?
I didn't mean to. I lost control of it. No, I really didn't mean to almost take your head off.
Yeah, I could tell by the way your face looked, you know, when you come by, you were really concerned with a huge smile on your face. Dude, it was close, and it didn't look like you were, like, going, oops, I'm sorry. You were, like, digging it. Kind of pissed me off.
I know, but even though we didn't have any stakes, I still wanted to win.
I kind of did, too, until after you were going to try to, you know, threaten my life.
The combination of the rain and Rob almost taking off his head puts Dennis in a stormy mood.
That's a little ridiculous, really. Seriously. Now, if I'd have done that to you, you'd been pissed. You'd probably be crying right now.
Yeah, I'd probably be crying.
You would.
Not an ideal way for the boys to begin their trip through Thailand.
What about southern Thailand? This rain is horrendous, isn't it?
It's like it's the monsoon and it's following us or something.
A little further inland from Phuket, the boys run across something that brightens Dennis's mood.
But you talking about something fun to play mud bogging and stuff in right there? We used to go slide riding, dude, with these hoods at home in the duck impoundment centers, just like the duck impoundments.
Dennis takes his mud seriously. Gravedigger was originally conceived as a mud bogger.
Hey, I've done it all my life, dude.
What is this? What is
this? That's like a little walk behind tractor. Look at the paddles on that thing, man. It's like some big old paddle tires.
So let's do it. Can we go mud bogging, mud sliding with this?
It'll probably trot pretty good, man. It's got tall tires on it.
What do we use to make a sled with?
We just need something flat that's got a nose
like
on it.
Like a piece of aluminum?
Yeah, or anything. You know your little walk behind tractor out there in the field? Yeah, I want to drag him through the mud.
Okay.
What can we use? Look at, he has all kinds of tools here.
There's a little stick welder.
Oxygen, acetylene.
Check this out, this will work perfect.
With free rein in the farmer's junkyard.
What do you think?
Sweet.
This will work, right?
The guys get busy monstering up a sled for a little slide riding.
Take that torch and burn this paint.
Okay.
Pull it till you cut on through so you don't wash it all back together. Nice. Oh, baby. Hey, ho, 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 ho!
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Don't. You're burning a hole through it. Let me see it. Set on it, Rob. Stand on it or something.
I got two handles.
That was a tie handle.
Let's do it. Easy. Oh, easy. Just take your shoes off. Oh, it's nasty. Ah. Oh, it's gross. Wait, wait, you tie on that side.
No, 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 you need to tie them together in the middle. Don't do that and spread them apart.
Why not?
You need to go through here.
Is that it?
Yep.
We're good, baby. Can you drive it?
Dude. Does a cat have a carburetor?
Huh?
This motor's brand new, but she's still got old school technology here.
How do you start it?
Right here.
Okay.
These two-wheel tractors, or iron buffaloes, make it easier for farmers to turn in the muddy rice paddies. This top-of-the-line working man's tool was invented by a Thai prince who probably never worked a day in his life. They call it good, clean fun.
Go, go, go!
But if you're still clean, it ain't fun.
It's kind of nasty, but it's fun.
All right, bird, let's go. Take off easy. No, no, no.
What are you doing? Why are you getting dragged in the mud?
Felt good, but I just got tired of holding on. Let me get your piggyback ride. Come on.
I was just kidding you.
All right. That was a muddy way.
I haven't seen you smile that big since we left California.
Coming up.
Look it, this thing's coming off.
All right, here it goes. Hold on.
After a close call on a longtail boat,
this here's called watermelon crawl.
And a little fun in the mud. We hosed the boys off and sent them on their way to Bangkok.
Dude, we gotta get to Bangkok, Rob.
What do you think? Can we make it?
You gotta be kidding me.
Monsoon rains have swollen this small pond into a deep pool.
Rob, you think we should really be doing this, dude?
I don't really know what other options we have, number one, Dennis. Number two, they obviously used it in the past.
So Dennis and Rob have been forced to go out on a limb to cross it.
Oh, there's no way.
Go for it.
There's no way, dude. Let me go, or unless you want to go first.
No, go for it.
Well, get off of it.
Well, I'm stabilizing it.
No, don't stabilize it. I'll stabilize myself. Oh, the problem is my shoes are all muddy. I'm going in the water. I can feel it. I might make it, but there's no way you're making it. Let's put it that way.
No, I'll be shocked if this bridge makes it.
Will you wait?
Hold on, dude. I'm still on the shore right here.
Just wait till I get off.
Oh,
oh, this is where it's gonna get you, Dennis.
Oh!
Not to make things worse, but look, it's a sewer pipe draining into this.
What the hell was that? They ain't got no gators out here, do they?
Not anything big enough to eat you. Woo. Easy, easy.
Why did we come this way?
Because how else are we gonna get across? Made it. My goodness.
Nice.
I would have been against. Come
on. I'm kind of proud of myself. That was pretty cool.
Our guys have seen a lot of ways to travel on this journey.
Look at that cab, Rob.
What is it?
This one has them buffaloed.
What is it? It looks like they're working on the cab, or they got it mounted.
It sits on top of it, and you can move it around.
No, but it's kind of mounted to it. Maybe they were fixing it up to pull it in a parade or something.
Hi, it's me, sir.
Oh, hi.
This is my house.
Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Rob. How are you?
I'm not.
What would you call this? What is this?
Buffalo cat.
Where are the buffalo? Yeah, oh, my goodness.
Two buffaloes.
So you actually hooked water buffalo up to this then?
When it's raining, I sit inside.
Right.
And I ride it to buffalo.
Right.
From my house to my farms.
Right.
Yeah.
So you stay dry then when it's raining. That's cool.
Yeah, it's very safety and dry.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, we could have used that a few hours ago.
Okay, you all right.
It's still a long way to Bangkok. These water buffaloes might be the perfect way to get there.
We'd like to rent it for a little while.
Oh, no problem. You can rent it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
How much?
How much? 2,000 per day. It's very cheap.
How about 1,500?
1,500. No problem.
Oh, you started too high.
No problem.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay.
God, these things are big, man.
What's his name?
Friday.
Friday.
Yeah. So in Thai.
And what's that one's name?
Saturday.
Friday and Saturday.
The domesticated Asian water buffalo is responsible for 80% of all farm power in Thailand. Weighing in at about a ton, it has the massive strength needed to pull plows through the swampy rice paddies of Southeast Asia.
Okay, let's go, buddy. Come on. Come on, Friday.
Yeah.
Okay, stop, stop. Stop.
Good. Oh, boy.
That looked like me when I was on the Liamba.
This is new. I think this is a fresh idea right here. I hope this works.
Nice. You think we got enough reins there?
Shut up and get in.
One, two, three.
Good Lord.
Woo! Let's go.
Okay. Good luck. Good luck.
Get it.
Rob and Dennis still have about 300 miles to get to Bangkok.
How do you make it turn?
Just figure it out. Pull this one. Tighten it up. Tighten it up.
At this rate, it'll take a lot of Fridays and Saturdays to get them there.
Oh, yeah. Get it, Daisy, mate.
No, no, go this way. This way. This way. Pull. No, the other one. Pull the other one.
Not. You gotta throw the thing over there.
Oh, Dennis, this is not funny, dude. He's a water buffalo.
Hey, here goes somebody's van.
Dennis.
How do you make them turn?
Dennis is a lifelong farm boy, but even that experience is no help when dealing with a couple of Thai water buffalo.
Just go this way. Just pull them this way.
You can't, dude. They can't make that turn.
Pull both the reins. Yes, they can. Tighten up the reins. Tighten them up.
Okay, Rob, you got the manual out there? You know exactly what we're doing then.
I know that you got to press to the left to go left and right.
Press, got to press to the
pull
left.
The...
It's automatic.
Do you want me to drive?
No.
You want me to show you how?
No, because it, no.
Two buffalo.
I know that, but now how do you go right? How do you go that way?
Pull that rope together.
I know that, and it makes him go left, Slick. I already did it, okay?
Shake it.
Both rope.
Both rope. Yes.
All right.
Shake them both.
Okay, go.
Who wants to go left? Shake it.
Move. Move. Ta!
Shake it. Shake it. Shake it. Shake it. There you go. There you go.
Here we go. We're going in the tree.
Shake it more. Shake it more.
Ah!
Now pull.
Here,
pull.
Wait.
Oh! Dennis!
Come on.
Dennis,
we're
gonna roll, dude.
Wait. Shut up. Hold on.
You're gonna fall on top of me.
Come on. We're killing their fig tree or whatever.
If your big ass falls on top of me, bro.
All right, here it goes. Hold on. Come on.
Dennis, we're gonna roll, dude.
Wait. Shut up. Hold on.
You're gonna fall on top of me.
Come on.
Rob and Dennis are trying to take a bite out of the nearly 300-mile journey to Bangkok on this water buffalo cart.
Killing their fig tree or whatever.
If your big ass falls on top of me, bro.
But the water buffaloes seem to have other ideas.
Hold on.
I told you.
Go to the right.
You're gonna take out the fence now, too.
Get out on the road, we'll tear some more up. There you go. There you go. They're pissed now.
Ah, I would be, too.
After a slow start, the buffalo kick it in.
They're gonna run off in the ditch.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are. Look at them.
Stop being so negative. Dennis, hold him tight.
No, he's pissed. I gotta give him some slack. Come on, get over here in the middle of the road.
Look at it, it's right on his neck. What do you think this is, a hybrid?
Hey, we're going green, baby. Uh-oh. Hey, this one's pissed. How in the hell do they ever train these things? This one's blind on the left. Tell the pickup to speed on up.
Wow, dude, he's chucking along now. Dennis, pull him over, pull him over.
Watch the bamboo. All right. Hey, the yoke is coming loose.
Look at, this thing's coming off.
Huh?
Oh, no, it's coming off.
They're fixing to crash. We're going down. She's going down. She's going down. Look. Here it goes. We got this one pinned in the neck.
Oh!
Ah! Whoa! Look, here it goes.
Dennis drove the buffalo a little too hard.
She's going down.
The yoke fell off the one on the right. Without support, the harness crashed to the ground.
Oh!
Ah!
That's enough. Dennis, get out.
Well, I got all this rope tied out around my feet.
Come on, dude.
Shut up.
Get out, Dennis.
Sarah?
Easy.
Hey, hold my money back.
Easy.
Woo. That's a sketchy way right there, buddy. I thought it was pretty cool, really. But look how far we did make it.
Yeah, not as far, 100
yards. Not as far as we wanted to.
Not as far as we needed to.
Well, anyway, it got us a little closer to Bangkok anyway, huh?
You are out of control.
To keep from being in Thailand till the next millennium, we gave our guys a little shove and flew them 80 miles outside Bangkok.
What are these called again?
Sandpan.
Man, this is crazy.
This is like bumper boats, dude.
This is the Rat Bari Floating Market. It's a series of man-made canals on the Mekong River. Since the 19th century, farmers have traveled here to sell their wares. And the boat they use serves as the guy's next way.
How many people they allow on this river?
I'm gonna get killed in a paddle boat. There's no method to the madness and there's no lanes.
Oh! They're getting mad. They're not happy.
Dude, this is a cluster.
Hey, Dennis, I'll race you to the end.
Where is the end?
All right, we'll race from this bridge to the next bridge.
All right, I can tell you, dude, it's gonna take a while.
The winner gets to decide what we're having for lunch.
All right, there we go.
Hold on. Stuck. Back, brother.
Go.
Dennis, wait there.
The race is on now.
Sorry.
All right, here we go.
Sorry about that last time.
Pardon me, excuse me. We're a disaster, man. We don't know what we're doing. Rob, you're on the wrong side, dude.
The wrong side? There's less traffic over here.
Oh, nice job.
Watch out. Ooh, here we go. We're getting some speed.
Whoa! Rob, be easy, dude. That's my back.
Sorry. Charlie's taking the lead! Come on! Don't yell at me, it's my first time.
It's just rude, Rob. He don't care, he's pissing everybody off.
Power through! Come on, Dennis!
It's all about Rob. As long as he's the hero, he'll be good today.
Whoa! Don't touch my boat! My boat!
All right. Thank you.
Sorry. I can see the finish line. I can't go slow, I'm in a race. Yeah!
Quite a victory there, Rob.
What happened?
Got in a traffic jam, dude.
That sounds like something the second place finisher would say. Give me five with your paddle. Come on, I got something good in mind for lunch for you.
Pick the poison, buddy, that's all I can say.
After crawling their way through the waters of the Rotbury market.
Okay, bring it in.
Rob's ordered up a loser's feast that'll make Dennis bug out.
Is it cooked?
You're gonna love it.
You gotta be kidding me. Grasshoppers?
Oh my God, that's a maggot.
...18,000 miles into their trip around the world.
This is crazy!
And 65 ways in the books.
Brakes.
Dennis and Rob are feeling the pinch.
Hey!
They've improvised on some new ways to keep their goal in sight.
So let's do it. Can we go mud bogging with this?
Yeah!
Oh!
Whoa!
Dennis lost a sampan race.
Yes!
Quite a victory there, Rob.
And now he has to pay up on his bet.
Oh, my God. Oh, both for him. Wow.
What is that, dude? Grasshoppers?
It looks like grasshoppers du jour. That means of the day. This is a delicacy here in Thailand.
Yeah, but it ain't in North Carolina. I can tell you that right now.
That's a silkworm.
Hold on. That looks like a giant maggot.
Taste it.
Oh, crap.
And that's crickets. Come on, you'll eat anything.
Oh, you're crazy, dude. I ain't gonna eat all this.
Damn.
Dennis, you said you'd be up for anything.
That right there, I don't care for now.
Listen, I didn't lose the race. You wanna save this one for last? Oh, I don't know how he does it.
Not bad.
Next time, put a little bit more effort into the race, and you won't lose.
Well, if I'd have known I was going to have to eat bugs like that, dude, I'd have knocked everybody out of the way.
Around 20 miles outside Bangkok, the boys roll up on a scene that has Dennis feeling right at home.
What is with the mud
everywhere?
I'm
telling you, dude, it's monsoon season. Obviously, the water table's up. This is low ground here.
You must be missing home. Are you missing home? Is that why we got all the mud? Are you missing home?
Yeah, baby, this is the mud season here.
Mud and motorist. This is Dennis's playground.
This is a salt pan, and I don't know exactly how it works, but some kind of way, the vapors, they'll squeegee this thing off with these rollers right here, and then they come out and harvest the salt.
To make salt, seawater is pumped into shallow fields and left to dry in the sun. As the water evaporates, salt crystals begin to form under the surface. Rollers are used to distribute the crystals more evenly and to speed up evaporation. Once the salt is dry, it can be collected into piles for harvest.
How do you work it? It looks like a little lawnmower engine.
It is. It's just a little 6.5 horsepower. But look, I like the little gearbox. It's got a reverser on it here.
Okay.
And it's got rear steer, so it's kind of like driving a forklift.
Because these rollers have a short wheelbase, we set up a slalom course to put Dennis and Rob's driving skills to the test.
All right, Dennis, tell me about the course.
What we're going to do is we're going to weave in and out of the slalom course, keep weaving our way all the way down the track.
Okay, first one to the water wins. What are we racing for?
I don't know, man. I don't want to race to eat no bugs, though. I know that.
You know what? They have a tradition here in Thailand where you go into a bath with these mini fish. They're like little piranhas, and they eat the dead skin. The loser has to go and have a fish spa day.
In with little piranhas? You got to be kidding me, dude.
Oh, you're going to love it. Let's do it. Fire them up.
Dennis uses his experience to get off to a quick start. But Rob has the faster roller. It looks like he's got this one in the bag. But then his engine dies. But before he can take the checkered flag, Dennis sticks his roller into a mud bank. It looks like a draw.
Ah, come on.
Until Rob rewrites the rules.
Glad I didn't have to run all that way. I didn't even know that you took off yet.
I know, because you said first to the end. You were too busy trying to get you unstuck. I got stuck too. I saw you messing around.
Nah, it was a piece of junk, dude. That was a failure, man. I swear.
Fifteen miles short of Bangkok.
I'm tired of walking through the mud. The sludge.
Well, I'm sick of all these bright ideas. We just need to find a consistent way to get there.
Dennis and Rob are ready to find a way, any way, to get off their feet and into the city.
Oh, my goodness. What is... Look at this.
The guy's prayers have just been answered.
I think pulls to the left.
There's a scooter with a phone booth on the side of it, with me riding in it.
Actually, Dennis, it's a monk mobile. They've welded a simple steel cage to a 150cc scooter, similar to the Pope mobile. It protects the monks from danger while allowing them to interact with their flock. It's supposed to be driven slowly. Apparently, Rob didn't get the memo.
Don't be squirrely. Look at that. You see that little tuk-tuk thing? Look at them. They're awesome right there. Don't try to keep up with him.
You know, what is this thing supposed to be?
Huh? It's a monk-mobile.
A monk-mobile. You know what monks do? They take a vow of silence. So just shut up. This is Bangkok, baby.
Can't believe it. We haven't even had a crash yet.
I figured you'd pick a city called Bangkok after Titicaca.
After 500 miles through a rainy season in Thailand, the guys have made it to Bangkok. Home to more than 9 million people and almost 6 million cars, with 500 more being added to its already congested roads every day.
Hold on now.
God.
What happened to the throttle on this thing?
Don't put me in the other lane, you dip. You're a crappy driver, dude. I'm telling you.
Oh, stop. Excuse me.
You keep your eyes on the road there, Super Mouth.
Oh, we're not in India? Hold on, we're backing up. I thought we were in India again.
Drivers actually obey traffic laws in Thailand.
Go, go, go.
Now that they've made it to Bangkok, their next goal is to make it to the hotel in one piece.
You hear this?
Here it comes. Luckily, I got my rain jacket.
The whole wheel's
brake, you gotta use the back brake, son.
Not the brakes.
Use
the
back brake, you idiot.
The road's all wet.
Getting wet. How about let me have that coat? You don't care about anybody else. You got your raincoat on. I'm sitting here getting rained on.
You're a lot of other people. Just not one of them right now.
The relentless monsoon has a way of dampening spirits and shortening tempers.
Dude, this is nuts.
Come on, pull this thing over. I'll tell you one thing, dude.
Oh, stop crying. With all the stuff you put me through this whole trip.
Yeah. Thank God.
Dennis and Rob bail out of the Monkmobile.
Can we have a ride? Can we go with you?
But before they head to their hotel to wait out the rain, Dennis has a bet to pay. At a fish spa.
My friend here needs a full treatment. How much?
15 minutes, 150.
No, not 15 minutes. I want the full treatment.
Dr. Fish like these feed on dead skin cells, providing a therapeutic effect. If you don't mind having hundreds of miniature piranhas swarming your unprotected feet.
Take care, my boy. Only the best for you, Dennis. Hop in. Look at the teeth on those things. I think the fish might be repelled.
Oh. You're like a pack of wolves. Look at that. Oh, my God. Oh, man. Stick your hand in there.
I'm not doing that. Are you kidding me?
It's kind of weird, really. It feels like it's shocking you. Look at him. They're climbing all the way up here.
Man, I can't believe those fish are going near those feet. Lift them up out of the water. Let me see. Oh, that's gross. You had enough?
No, I like it now.
Oh, God.
Sometimes it pays to lose.
Coming up.
What's it right here?
Can you pedal this thing with high heels?
This is an epic failure. Watch out for the cow.
Another night in Thailand, another night of rain. But Dennis and Rob aren't gonna let a little water keep them from enjoying the nightlife in Bangkok.
There you go. I love them new briefs.
Because you never know what might be around the corner on these exotic streets.
Come on, come on. Who wants a ride here? Please. Who needs a ride? Who needs a ride? Come here. Come here. Who needs a ride? This ride is beautiful. Ah, come here.
How much for a ride?
Oh, 200 baht.
No. We just want to go for a bicycle ride.
Okay. All right, let's go.
Thank you.
Pedicabs are just tricycles with an extra back seat. In Thailand, tricycles are called samlaw, which literally means three wheels. Since they were easier to ride, tricycles were used by riders who did not feel comfortable on high two-wheelers, such as children and women who wore long dresses.
Okay, let's go. Can you pedal this thing with high heels?
Woo! That was close!
I'm doing good. Oh, dude. Okay, this is not working.
Rob's starting to feel a little uncomfortable. He's not sure his driver knows how to ride a trike.
No. Do you want me to drive?
Where's the brakes at? Is there no brakes?
This may be the first time Dennis has ridden in a pedicab.
All right, where's Rob and them at? Rob! Hold on. Wait, let's wait for Rob. Push the pedal backwards.
But he knows his way around a tranny.
Come on now, watch out for the curb. Have you been drinking? Yeah. Yes, no, drive straight. Watch out for the car. Watch out for the cab. Get up there with my buddy, will ya? Oh! This is an epic failure.
My God, where's your friend?
I don't know, I wish he'd come on.
Rob's driver got away from our cameras.
Watch out for the car!
And crashed into an oncoming car, nearly taking off Rob's exposed leg.
Oh!
With rain coming down and one of our guys hurt,
almost lost my leg, dude.
It's time to cut our losses for the evening.
I'm done. I'll be back at the hotel.
Rob and Dennis's ride on the wild side,
guys, we're calling it a day,
comes to an abrupt end. That was one night in Bangkok Rob won't forget soon enough. But before they leave Thailand, the boys are checking out their most explosive way yet. Home-brewed Thai rockets, or Bang Fei, are launched in local festivals to celebrate the beginning of the rainy season. The practice evolved from early Buddhist fertility rites featuring phallic-shaped totems. The invention of gunpowder in 9th century Asia finally enabled the totems to achieve maximum thrust.
Now that's a rocket.
I don't know who told you you could ride a rocket. It's a big bottle rocket.
Yeah, but they got them bigger than that.
You guys have a bigger rocket?
Well, we have bigger rockets.
They said a man can ride on them.
Yes, a man can ride on them.
Bring it over. I want to see it.
Time out. We don't want to end this series yet. So instead of letting our two dummies strap on these rockets, we're going to test it on a real dummy first.
Five.
Wait.
Four.
Wait.
Oh, come on. Really, dude?
All right, ready? Five, four, three, two, one, blast off!
Yeah, that's a way. Straight to the emergency room.
I think the helmet was too heavy.
You think the helmet was too heavy? You think that's what the problem was? Oh, my goodness.
Jeez.
Where's the guy's head?
I wonder where the rest of his head is.
One more time and it will be perfect.
Next time.
Thanks, we'll take a rain check. This week, Rob and Dennis successfully found 7 new ways to get to Bangkok, Thailand. First, they cruised to the mainland on a couple of long-tail boats, dragged each other through the mud, nearly crashed a buffalo cart,
this one's pissed,
raced some sandpans through a crowded market, played slip and slide on a couple of salt pan rollers, mounted a monk mobile,
don't you shut up,
and had a close shave on a couple of tranny cabs.
No. Oh.
Only 12 more ways to go.
All right, where are we going next?
Man, I don't know, Dennis. I think I had enough. I think I'm ready to go home.
We've made it to Thailand. I'm gonna tell you right now, man, what a place to be.
Oh, yeah.
For the most part, our journey has been quite fun.
Watch these cars. Don't put me in the other lane, you dip.
You know, I was the fool in the monk mobile. Looked like I'm riding around in a telephone booth. Well, I've got Rob jerking and snatching all the way down the road, agitating me, you know.
You know, at the outset of this journey, we were given the objective to circumnavigate the globe using 80 different forms of transportation without repeating any of them. And we're almost there. Stay tuned. We're gonna finish this up, and we're coming home.